7, 8, and again 1, 2, and point 3, 4, flex 5, 6, 7, 8. We're going to do this for 4 counts of 8, and whenever your students are flexing their feet, you want to try and tell them to lift their heels up off the floor. So they're pressing the backs of their knees down to the ground, so there's no space there, lifting the heels up off of the floor, okay? Ready to start it. We flex 1, 2, heels up, 3, 4, we flex 5, 6, and point, and flex 4 counts of 8, and point, and flex, lifting the heels, chins up nice and tall, 2 more counts of 8, 1, 2, flex, 8 point, sorry, and flex, chin up,
thank you.
sitting up nice and tall. We're going to take it all the way down to the stretch, or pike stretch. Good. We're going to hold it there. From there, we're going to keep the spine curved, rolling it back down. Keeping the head down. Nice and slow. Back to the position, okay? Keeping these toes pointed the whole time. Seven, here we go. And one, two, three, touch your toes. And roll down. Six, seven, down on eight, and up. Two, three, four, and down. Six, seven, eight, again. One, two, your tummy, three, stretch. Roll down.
About working all of these back muscles. Hold, off my arm, lift.
foot exercise in the straddle position. So they're going to place their arms behind their head again, right? So we're sitting up nice and tall, looking at the camera, right? Big smiles. We're going to point one, so we're going to start with the pointed feet. Okay, so we flex one, two, we point three, and four, and flex five, six, seven, eight. We're going to do that for about four counts of eight. And again, it's the same thing from the pike position. You want to make sure that they're pressing down the backs of their knees into the ground, and their heels should be just a little bit lifted up off the floor, okay? Yes, we're activating all of these leg muscles. And then we're going to take a nice stretch forward at the end, walking the hands out to the center with pointed feet first. And then we'll flex the feet, staying in the stretch. Seven.
Two counts.
ball with nice straight elbows. Okay, this is gonna help them keeping this nice flat back. Okay, versus having the arms on the floor again and lift it up. Okay, we're gonna start with pointed feet. We're gonna flex 1, 2, and 0.3, 4, and flex 5, 6, 7, 8, flex 1, 2, and 0.,  and flex and point, okay? So we're gonna do this for a couple counts of 8, and again, you wanna just sneak your hand underneath your student's knees and make sure they're pressing your fingertips down into the floor and lifting those heels up off the floor as much as they can. Okay, it's a little bit harder to shadow, isn't it? To push on my fingers. Stretching you, yeah. Nice and tall. And flex 1, 2, 3, 4. Flex 5, 6, 7, and 8. You flex 1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
into a turned out position. So we're going to flex, we're starting parallel. We're going to lift the toes up, one, two, turn it out on this heel, three, four, put the toes down, five, six, plie, seven, stretch, eight. Then we're going to reverse, lifting up the toes, one, two, turn it parallel, three, four, put the toes down, five, six, plie, bend in parallel, seven, stretch, eight, okay? So again, we lift the toes, we turn it out, we put it down, we plie, we lift the toes, we turn it in, we put it down, we plie, ready? Okay, so we want to try and make sure, try not to look down all the time, try to look nice and straight. So we have to use our brains to make sure that we know the combination, right?
Keep pushing those knees out to the side and stretch.
plie, and stretch and finish.
Developing their leg muscles. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
center work. We're gonna place our hands on our hips. We're gonna do some tendu leg lifts. Okay, we're gonna tendu our right leg out. One, two, we're gonna lift up. Three, four, hold. Five, six, tendu. Seven, close. Eight, left. One, two, and lift. And hold. Tendu, close. We're gonna do four to the front. Then we're gonna take it four to the side. Okay, so when we go to the side, it's okay if your working leg turns out, but the supporting leg is just gonna stay parallel for now because it's asking too much of the rotators at a younger age. So we're gonna keep it nice and parallel. So we're working on developing, you know, the strength, the stability, and the muscles that they need to progress in ballet. So staying parallel, take one step back for me, see. There we go. Okay, ready? Let's get started.
A really cool list of
and you're just gonna jump side to side, jump side and side. Okay, so we're gonna start from back to front first.
Thank you, Chace, for demonstrating, and we will see you for our next lesson.